Hello dear students, welcome back. In the last video, we learnt how to prepare revaluation account. In this session, we will be learning accounting treatment of accumulated profits and reserves. So let's do question number 12. Please take out question number 12 of your textbook on page number 141. Here is the question. Alay and Sanket are the partners of a partnership firm. Profit loss sharing ratio among them is 2:1. As on 31st March 2017, the following are the balances in the books of firm. First, profit loss account, that is debit balance, 18,000. Reserve fund, 27,000. Workers Profit Sharing Fund, 33,000. Workers Accident Compensation Fund, 21,000. On the above date, Alay and Sanket decided to change their profit loss sharing ratio to 1:1. A claim of rupees 6,000 is outstanding payable to workers against Workers Accident Compensation Fund. Here we have to past necessary journal entries showing distribution of accumulated profit losses in the books of the firm. So here is the answer of question number 12. See, if at the time of change in the profit sharing ratio, reserves or accumulated profits losses exist in the books of the firm, they are transferred to the partners' capital accounts if capitals are fluctuating, or the current accounts if capitals are fixed in their old profit sharing ratio. The reason for transfer to the partners' capital accounts or current accounts in their old profit sharing ratio is that the partners should not be placed at an advantage or disadvantage. Now, why do we distribute it in old profit sharing ratio? See here, the reserves and accumulated profits losses as on the date of change in profit sharing ratio have come into existence before the reconstitution of the firm. Therefore, the reserves and accumulated profit losses are transferred to the partners' capital accounts or current accounts in their old profit sharing ratio. So here are the journal entries. See here, the first balance in the books of firm is given profit loss account, and that is to debit balance. Debit balance of profit and loss account indicates that it is accumulated loss. If profit and loss account has credit balance, if it is given in bracket that it is credit balance, then it indicates that it is accumulated profit. But here debit balance is given in the bracket, that means it is loss, accumulated loss, which is 18,000. So how we are going to distribute it? As I just explained to you, it will be distributed between old partners in their old profit and loss sharing ratio, which is 2:1, which is given in question. So if 18,000 will be distributed in 2:1 ratio, then we will get 12,000 and 6,000. Here, partners' capital account will be debited and profit and loss account will be credited. We know that profit and loss account, which is showing debit balance, that means it is accumulated loss. And as we know, loss shows debit balance, but here it is credited because we are transferring that loss to partners' capital account. Because we are transferring it, that's why profit and loss account will be credited. And as we know, capital account has always credit balance. And if any kind of reduction is there in capital account, then in that case, capital account will be debited. That's why, as it is a loss, that's why in this case, Alay's capital account and Sanket's capital account will be debited. Now in the question, some more balances are given, like reserve fund, workers profit sharing fund, which is 33,000, workers accident compensation fund, which is 21,000. Please read the question along with me. Here, if we talk about workers profit sharing fund, which is 33,000, so here workers profit sharing fund is liability. So liability will not be distributed. So for that, you just have to write one note that as workers profit sharing fund is liability, so it will not be distributed. And for remaining balances, which are given, reserve fund and workers accident compensation fund. 27,000 is for reserve fund and balance of workers accident compensation fund is 21,000. Here, in case of workers accident compensation fund, along with its balance, one more information is given in the question, that is, a claim of rupees 6,000 is outstanding payable to workers against workers accident compensation fund. First, let us understand what is workers accident compensation fund. Workers accident compensation fund is one kind of reserve created for payment of compensation in case of accident. And if no compensation is payable in future, the entire amount is to be distributed among the partners in the old ratio. But here in the question, it is given that a claim of rupees 6,000 is outstanding payable to workers. So as the balance of workers accident compensation fund is 21,000, which is given in question, and claim is there of rupees 6,000. So 21,000 minus 6,000, that is 15,000 will be distributed to partners. See, these reserves are created from the divisible profit of a partnership firm, and the balance of the accumulated profit, if any, are of existing partners of the firm. Therefore, at the time of reconstruction of a partnership firm, all these balances like reserve funds and the balance of accumulated profit, workers accident compensation fund, all these reserves are distributed amongst the existing partner in their old profit sharing ratio. And as these are created from profit, so if profit will be distributed to partners in their capital account, then in that case capital account will be credited. As you know, capital account has always credit balance, and if there is any addition to the capital, as we know, due to profit, there is addition in the capital. That's why here partners' capital account will be credited, and reserve fund and workers' accident compensation fund account will be debited, as these are profit, accumulated profit. These are debited because we are transferring it to partners' capital account. Though these accumulated profit has credit balance, but as we are transferring it to partner's capital account, that's why it will be debited. So let's see the calculation here. See, we have balance of reserve fund 27,000 and workers accident compensation fund 15,000, which is equals to 42,000. And old ratio of partners is 2:1. If we distribute it according to this ratio, Alay will get 28,000 out of 42,000 and Sanket will get 14,000 out of 42,000. So here's the journal entry. Reserve fund account debit, workers accident compensation fund account debit 15,000, to Alay's capital account 28,000, to Sanket's capital account 14,000. So in this way, we have to distribute reserves and accumulated profit among the partners. And in this way, we have to pass journal entry for that. So that's it for today. Thank you very much.